What's up, guys? I'm Joshua Paul from Confide, and you are watching barebonesmusic.com.
ELG, barebonesmusic.com. I'm here with Joshua Paul.
What's going on?
Confide. Hey, thanks for joining us, man.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.
In this lovely setting here where you see we're hanging out in their palatial van with all their gear. Kind of a first for us here. Cameraman's getting caught on stuff, but hey, we're winging it out here. First of all, I want to ask about your guys' lineup. I'd asked you this a little bit earlier, but Jeffrey is the only original member of the band.
Correct.
Ross came in 2007.
Yeah, he came in from England, yeah.
And so Joel, yourself, and Trevor came in last year. How are you guys gelling as a band after this short period of time? I mean, how are you guys mixing?
That's going well. We came in kind of in a, I don't know, we came in at different times. I actually started working for Confide in 2008. I joined them on Warped Tour. I quit my band in Texas, flew out literally the next day to Michigan. I just did merch and teching for them for Warped Tour. Did the same thing for Mailing and Sons of Disaster Tour and then Bring Me the Horizon Tour. I worked for them for about 6 months and then moved back to California with them because I didn't really have anywhere to go. And then I was going to start playing music in a different band, and then they lost their guitar. So I'm like, hey, do you want to play for us? And I was like, why not? Let's do it. So I just got I got an upgrade from merch to playing guitar in the band.
So. Well, that's pretty cool. I mean, so you guys gelling well on stage?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you're finding your synergy as a band,
and
as a unit?
It definitely helped working for them for 6 months. I got to see how they, how they performed as a band together, how they acted as, just fooling around in the van and having fun as friends. So once I was officially in the band as a member, we all already were like best friends. So it gelled really easily. And then with the addition of Joel and Trevor, it kind of just within a couple months of each other, we knew them prior to the time as well. So it all worked out really well.
So you have a new album coming out in May called Recover.
Yes.
Yeah. Any secrets or any
secrets?
Any dish you can give us about the new album?
Because
I know you had there was a thing on Twitter about it, and it was kind of mysterious. It's like, well, here's the name. We'll let you know when it's actually coming out in May.
We do have the release date, but I don't know if we're allowed to say it. It's not like it's top secret or anything, but we just, we don't want it to get it pushed back a week or so,
right.
Just, for whatever reason. So it is coming out in May. We don't know if we can say exact what day yet, but it is called Recover. There's going to be 11 tracks on the CD. The last album, Shout the Truth, had two interlude tracks. This one is just straight music, front to back, first song to the last song. No pretty parts or anything like that. It just gets straight to the point. So it's a lot different, but it's still the same from Shout the Truth.
Right.
It's a lot heavier, but it's also a lot more mainstream and poppier and more marketable. Mm-hmm. But it's still very much Confide, and I think our old fans will love it, and I think we'll gain a lot more new fans off of it too. So,
I mean, do you guys consider yourselves a Christian band? Is that something
It's something that obviously a lot of people bring it up. We're all five of us Christian dudes in the band.
Right.
Obviously, there is a Christian market out there, and there's a mainstream market. We don't consider us in the Christian market, so we don't consider that we're a Christian band.
Right.
Just because we are pushed more to the mainstream market.
Right.
So we don't call ourselves a Christian band, but we all are five dudes that are Christians, and we play music just to meet a ton of people across the world and just show them, that we love them just as much as they love us and they love our music, and that we just want to have a good time and hang out. So.
Well, that leads you to a question leads well into one of my questions was that not being considered a Christian band in the mainstream, do you think that Christian metalcore, metal, all that kind of stuff is being pushed more into the mainstream with bands like Under Oath and Devil Wears Prada? And I mean, all these bands are really kind of coming to the forefront of the metalcore and metal scene.
I think they're kind of in the same position as us. Like you said, Under Oath and Devil Wears Prada, all Christian dudes. And I think they're the same thing. Like they are marketed in the Christian market, but that's not their main focus. Like, if we wanted to be a Christian band and be a Christian worship band and just sing praises and do worship songs and reach out to all Christian people, that's rad for bands to do that. But we're all five Christian dudes that want to reach out to the kids that don't know God and don't know God's love, and not pressure on them in any way, right. Not try to make them Christians or tell them that Christianity is better than them or anything else, because sure. We're all unperfect dudes, 100%. We mess up every day, but we just want to be there for support. Like, we want to be there for kids to talk to about anything, no matter what it is, and we can tell them, you know, we mess up every day just as much as you do, if not more. So that's just, I think it's something that a lot of bands are doing. Like you said, Under Oath, same thing. They're all Christian dudes, but I don't think they consider themselves in the Christian markets.
So. Right. Do you think you guys have like a crossover appeal to like the metal and metalcore and like punk scenes as well, with your type of music, with your style of music? I think it kind of crosses all kinds of genres.
There are so many genres out there now because there's so many bands with so many different styles. Like, it's, you can't even name everything out there. Even with the turnouts at shows, you can't really tell. Like Black Veil Brides is on this tour as well, and they're different than every band on this tour, but their fans like our band and our fans like their band. So I think every band out there, no matter if they're, you know, a Christian metalcore band or just a straight metal band, like, different fans can like different styles of music. Like me, I play in a heavy band, but when I drive around on tour and when I'm at home, I listen to country music, but no one would ever know that. Like, I love country music more than I love this kind of music, but this is what, you know, I know God wants me to do. So I think any type of people can listen to any type of music. So,
the Royal Family's clothing tour is about halfway through. And after you get done with this, heading on to the Warped Tour.
Actually, even before Warped Tour, we're going to Europe.
Yeah. Oh, you're going to Europe.
We go, we get 10 days off at home, and we actually go to Europe with I Set to Kill, which is rad because we're on this tour with I Set to Kill. Mm-hmm. Go to Europe for 26 days, no days off. It's just fly out there, play 26 shows in a row in 11 different countries,
right. Fly
back home, have a month off, and then Warped Tour, which is as well with I Set to Kill as well. They'll be on Warped.
What is your expectations of Warped Tour?
I know Confide did it in 2008. They did just the second half of it, mm-hmm. and that's when I was still working for them, and that went really well. And I think two years later, our fan base has grown way more than it ever was before, and the new CD comes out right before Warped Tour starts. So if all goes as planned, I think it's going to be a great summer for us, for sure.
Awesome. One last question. You guys are, you know, you're a freshly structured band, mm-hmm. as a whole now. Yeah. What's going to be the key to longevity for Confide?
I think the key to it is the fact that we all came together right before this new record was recorded. And I think definitely, you know, the fact we all are Christian dudes, we all feel like God put us in the right places at the exact right time to make us come together right before this new CD and write it together, because all of our heads were in the exact same position and exact same thought process of how we wanted the CD to sound. And I think all of us coming together right then kind of just solidified the fact that we will be together for a while. You know, if a member change does come, we obviously can't play out the future for whatever reason if it did happen. But I think with this new CD, it brought us together, being in the studio for 2 months and days us wanting to kill each other because recording is terrible. And then days we had a ton of fun because tracked some guitars, then we played Halo all night long. So I think it's going to be a good time. And the fact that we're on tour for the next 6 months straight without hardly any breaks is definitely bonding us more than anything else could have. So.
All right. Well. Josh from Confide, Recover, out in May. I don't know the actual date, but be looking for it. Yeah. Catch them in Europe if you're in Europe, and catch one more Warped Tour this summer. Josh, thank you very much. Appreciate it so much.